Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Phoevos Pouroulis. He's the CEO of Tharisa PLC. Phoevos, very good to speak with you again.
Good morning. How are you, Stephen?
Very well, thank you. So Phoevos, you're recently out with your interim results and your two commodity strategy really paying off during that interim period.
Yeah, absolutely, Stephen. I think we've sort of proven the resilience of the co-production model of platinum group metals and chrome concentrates. And they're almost counter-cyclical in their pricing environment and really driven by different fundamentals, but nonetheless, both strong looking into the medium and long term. I think the real standout were the chrome prices for the first 6 months at $288 per tonne, up almost 16% from the prior period. But that in context of a 40% drop in PGM prices at $1,344 per tonne. But notwithstanding that, our volumes of chrome concentrate were up about 10% from the prior period, and really a focus on getting that tonnage out at around 870,000 tonnes for the 6 months. And I think what's pleasing is that we've seen the market react even more positively to physical demand, registering spot prices today of around $315 per ton. So a really buoyant pricing environment. And as I say, a balanced market by all accounts, with supply just meeting demand. And really, there have been some green shoots of demand in the stainless steel sector with new applications, whether it be rebar or replacement of water pipes with stainless steel. And you can imagine with a higher copper price environment, substitution becomes a reality, and stainless steel being corrosive resistant is a great alternative.
So while the two of those balanced out, your EBITDA was in line with the prior period for the 6 months. And at the same time, you continued investing in growth and you also continued with your share buyback program, Phoevos.
Yeah, I think the market responded really well to the share buyback. We announced it during a closed period in March. It's a $5 million share repurchase program. And it's not limited by time, but really by quantum. And we've seen a positive trajectory with that. And I think pleasing as well is that our board maintained the capital discipline of returning cash to shareholders in the form of a dividend, and we declared an interim dividend of 1.5 US cents, which is in line with our capital policy of returning 15% of net profit after tax to shareholders. So on a combined basis, if we take the share repurchase and the dividend, a very good reallocation of capital to our shareholders.
In fact, when we last spoke, Phoevos, and we chatted about the share buyback program, and you were saying that lower PGM prices were weighing on your share price, which is what had created the opportunity for the share buyback. Since we spoke, your shares are up 61%, so that really has worked in your favor.
Yeah, it has. And I think the realization that the chrome market is buoyant and demand is strong. There are supply side constraints, and we're perfectly positioned and leveraged to take advantage of this buoyant market. And as I say, prices up 10% from the half when we look at the spot market. So potentially a strong second half.
How are you seeing the PGM markets at the moment, Phoevos?
So we've seen a slight uptick post Platinum Week in London. So I think general consensus around the current market conditions, support for platinum prices, rhodium. Palladium is a bit of a different story with potential overhang of recyclable inventories, in the next 2 to 3 years. So we've seen that price being capped at just below $1,000, but some movement in terms of platinum. So we've seen prices up around 10% when we look at our basket price. So some early signals that we perhaps have hit the bottom of the pricing environment. And it really depends on a couple of factors, one of which is interest rates. So a big factor in terms of replacement of automobiles are the interest rate environments across the globe and the buying patterns of new car purchases, and also the scrapping of vehicles. People are keeping their secondhand or used vehicles for longer periods of time. We're seeing that, extending to 15 years to 18 years, which is considerably longer than what historically has been the norm.
Making progress with your redox battery project at the same time, Phoevos?
Yeah, very exciting. We're busy deploying 3 demonstration units at the moment, 2 in Germany and 1 in South Africa. And those are upscaled units, 200 kilowatt units. And that's really to prove the scalability of that. And those will be up and running during the course of this year. And then the schedule is to go to megawatt scale early next year and then to commercialization. So a fast track deployment and commercialization strategy, and really filling a gap that's desperately needed. The renewable energy space is abundant, but storage is lacking, and cost-effective storage at sort of utility scale is the missing link at the moment. And we believe that Redox One can fill that gap.
Phoevos, how's the second half of your financial year looking so far, particularly regarding production?
Yeah, so production is stable and consistent. We guiding the consistent guidance that we put out at 1.7 to 1.8 million tons of chrome concentrate and between 145 and 155,000 PGM ounces. So we're comfortable with that guidance, and going well. I think in light of the challenges in South Africa, it's a good outcome. We are facing a number of headwinds, whether it be utilities. Fortunately, we've had limited or no load shedding for the last few months, but logistics constraints are a factor. And as you know, we are in the middle of deciding a coalition or a government of unity at the moment. So some volatility in the environment that we operate in.
Well, hopefully prices continue to play in your favor though. Phoevos, thank you very much for the update today. Look forward to chatting with you again soon.
Thank you, Stephen. Take care.
That's Phoevos Pouroulis. He's the CEO of Tharisa PLC.